Okay, so in this video, I'm going to be doing the hidden challenge for Darker Shore, where it's reach wave 40 by only spending 10,000 points. It's one of the challenges for the banker, I believe. Yeah, I already did it on my other account like a long time ago, so I'm just doing it on this one so I can actually, show me getting the challenge done. This is the loadout I was using. And just the consumable is just a double skeleton key and a double blitz machine. I don't have anything better.
It's too soon for us to be back in the field. Ardor was wrong to send us out.
Yeah. Anybody else wish he hadn't survived the train wreck? Oh,
shit. I watched you at a briefing. You don't like this place.
What is it? Ardor said you'd been here before.
Yeah, well, this place has got some history. Poking out of the sea like Lucifer's middle finger. Surprised stroke came here to this piece of shit island. I'm just wondering why we followed him.
Just doing that so I can get armor. Yeah, sorry, the audio is a little bit loud. Well, for me at least. Yeah, I'm only going to use the skeleton keys on the expensive doors. I gotta let the fog come in so I can have some more points. Yeah, I'm not gonna talk throughout the whole video. I'll say a few things here and there, but for the most part, I'm just gonna be trying to concentrate on not dying. Just need a few more points. It's crazy how the non-upgraded saw does like infinite melee damage, but the upgraded one doesn't.
Ah!
Okay, I'm gonna use my last discount on this. So I have 500 points exactly left to spend. Which means I can buy another self-revive if I go down. Because if you just go down normally without the quick revive perk, you'll lose like 10% of your points when you go down, which counts as spending points towards this challenge, which is pretty dumb. A small detail that I like is that the zombies that wear helmets actually receive less headshot damage than the zombies that don't wear helmets. Like that the zombie didn't have one. Let me see if I can find another one. It took two shots to kill that zombie with the helmet compared to the ones that don't. Yeah, that's just a cool little attention to detail. Although I think I saw a video one time that said that those old helmets actually weren't meant to protect from bullets, just like flying shrapnel and debris. But like, if you hit their helmets at an angle, they might have a chance at deflecting them, but for the most part, they pretty much didn't. Yeah, so you really don't want to train in one place because you can get overwhelmed pretty easily. Just sort of gotta walk your way around the map instead of just staying in one area. Yeah, because on the higher rounds they spawn in really fast. Okay, that was a bit of a stupid move. I thought there was more zombies, that's the only reason I One for the nuke. Yeah, whenever the fog comes in, I like to go up to this spot just for a little bit. And that's why I picked that loadout. Yeah, I don't really need the double points anyway. Doing this, it's just best to just walk along and just kill the zombies as you go. Yeah, and always check behind you. You never know what's there. There's just a heart in a dish right there. The fog's coming in. You can see it in the background. I heard it scream over there. Yeah, I hear it coming. It gets trickier after round 20, because after round 20 and up, you know, two of them spawning at a time. Whenever the fog comes in. Yeah, if you can't kill them both, the best thing to do is try to survive until the fog goes away. Try to get that heart. That's even better. hate it when they run like that. It looks so weird. Does get tedious after a while because you just really gotta kill the zombies one by one. I really don't know any other strategies for this challenge. That's why I chose to get stamina. Use my camouflage unless I absolutely have to. I'm 20, halfway there. Thank you.
my neighbor, nigga!
honestly, I'm glad my mic was muted at that time, because I screamed pretty loud when that fucking nuclear jumped out of nowhere. Well, he didn't jump out of nowhere, he was hiding. Because when you're far enough away from them, they crouch down and wait for you. A little hairy. I should have brought something else besides sniper, but I don't have the good guns unlocked because I haven't done all the Easter eggs on this account yet. I probably should though. Thank you. honestly, I can't believe I made it out of there. Ah, got both of them. Some armor, but I got the nuke. Yeah, in the later rounds, you definitely want to try to save your special as much as possible. Because it does get harder to refill it. How did that miss? Usually those guys' spines are always charged. How'd that miss again? Come on. It's always the bombers that are last. Okay, only 5 more waves. Okay, I know there's another one somewhere. It's easier to deal with one than two. Okay, the fog is going away anyway.
Come on. Thank you.
Okay, one more round. I had 500 left, so has to be spent anyway. Hell yeah. Yeah. Whew. More energy, take your time. Yeah, speaking of time, it took like an hour and 40 minutes. Damn. Alright. And I had zero downs. Yep. Okay, hour and 43 minutes. Whew. Okay, well, that's the end of that challenge, so I don't got nothing much to say, but I guess see you in the next one.